So now they're going to have to really rely on the draft and, like I said, bargain shopping and free agency. So we'll see how that works out for them. They were able to give us two surprises last year. Now, here we are 12 months later. It'll be interesting to hear how people would grade the moves of them signing Derek Watt to the deal that they signed him to.
Oh, it was terrible at the time.
Ebron.
We were talking about that. That was bad.
Right. But then even Eric Ebron's deal, like if you look at it 12 months later, how do people feel about that in terms of his cap hit versus his productivity? We know that he has a very high ceiling, but we've seen, you know, the floor that he has in terms of not very consistent from a catching standpoint. We knew that coming into the season. For some reason, all of us forgot that because he was in the black and gold. We thought it would magically disappear. And then when those issues started to arise again, we were like, whoa, what's going on? He never drops it. And it's like, come on, man, he does. He definitely does. So that's another thing where you might be looking and saying, well, all right, should we potentially make some moves here? I mean, but you're not going to be able to do these things right now. So that's the big thing, you know? But yeah, but just going back to the whole Ebron and Derek Watt thing, 12 months later, how do you look at those deals right now? And knowing the cap situation we're in right now as well.
Ebron's cap hit? Do you know off the top of your head?
Oh, man, I will pull it up in a second.
I think it was around $6 million a year, right? I don't know if maybe some more of the cap hit takes place this season.
That's what I see.
I like the Ebron one still. I'm still good with it. Like if you told us whenever we signed him that the year that we got out of him would play out, yeah, it was maybe a little bit less than we would have expected, but yeah, I thought he played pretty solid.
All right, so are you ready?
Sure.
So in 2020, his cap hit was $3.5 million.
Yeah, in 2021, they extended it.
In 2021, that cap hit is $8.5 million. Okay? And they could cut him and
it was
to pay $2.5 million then.
Okay, it was a two-year, $12 million deal, $6 million a year technically, but they spread it out a little different. Wait, so what, if they cut him, they're only on the books for $2 million in dead cap?
2.5.
Oh, wow, 2.5
in dead cap.
So that is kind of a smart deal then. That's a good deal in my opinion, because now they have a decision.
I agree.
Now they have a decision, what do you do with Ebron? But if you got Ebron for, what was it, you said $3.5 million last year?
Yes.
And then a potential $2 million dead cap hit this year. So around $5-6 million total. I would take that for 1 year of Ebron for sure. Yeah. Now the decision is, do we bring him back or not?
Right. And what makes it interesting, obviously a guy that was recently released from Minnesota, Kyle Rudolph, you look at him and just the basic, and I didn't even want us to get into this conversation like that, but two things that make this so intriguing, right? Just because we're on the topic of this cap situation right now. You look at Eric Ebron, and I think his in terms of catch percentage this year, he was around that 50% mark, right? In terms of targeted passes, he caught 50% of them. You look at Kyle Rudolph this year, and I believe Kyle was up there in the 80s. He was 80%, but throughout his career, he's always been a high 70s, high 80s type of guy. Whereas with Ebron, I think his best year in terms of just catch completion or just catch percentage was in the 60s. I think it was his best time. So when I think of that, I'm like, man, I know Ebron's the better athlete. I know Ebron's going to give me more yards at the catch. I know Ebron gives me the higher ceiling, right? He has a chance to be dynamite, right? Just a beast at the tight end position. But we also know it's 50-50 when you throw him the ball. And we've seen how that can help us at times, but how it's hurt us at times as well. Whereas with Kyle Rudolph, way less from an athletic ability standpoint, but way more shorthanded. Reminds me more of Heath Miller at this stage of his career. Knows how to get open, knows how to make tough catches. You get a guy like that potentially right in that same $2.5, $3.5, $4 million range. You ask yourself, yeah, all right, well, which one would you rather have in that scenario? So I think like just what but basically what I'm trying to get into is we're going to have multiple scenarios where they're going to have tough decisions like this, and they're happening sooner than later because you're sitting at about 10 days before the new league year starts. So you don't have a ton of time to just, you know, drag your feet with this thing, but that's definitely something that they're going to need to consider.